Yo, so guys, I went to a store today and I spent more money. That's where I went. If you guys live in Southern California and San Francisco and I think Berkeley area, you know this place, Amoeba Music. It is fucking heaven. You can find everything here, from 8-tracks to cassette tapes to DVDs to Blu-rays, VHS, fucking. And anything you want here, it's fucking awesome. Buy, sell, trade, everything. I bought some movies today. Now, I bought some movies that I had like 1,000 years ago, and I don't know what happened to them, so it's kind of like starting back over again. Like I told some of you guys before, like I'm getting back on my feet again, so yeah, let me show you what I got. Good deals. Boom. Friday the 13th. Little hologram cover. You know what it's about. You know the deal. $7. $7. Texas Chainsaw Massacre. $5. Has the insert and all that shit. $5. $5 freaking. Halloween. $6. And also, I don't know if some of you know, but I heard about it. I found it here today. It's a documentary on everything you want to know about the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. I haven't watched all the way through yet, but it's pretty cool. It has this is the first documentary ever made about this, on this movie. It has like interviews with Leatherface, the hitchhiker, Grandpa, the cook, and some never before seen photos supposedly and all this shit. But yeah, this is like $7. Pretty cool. I'm gonna watch it later, probably tomorrow. And this is, I've never seen this movie. It's called Chasing Sleep. It's with Jeff Daniels of all people, and he's like usually a comedy Dumb and Dumber and shit. And it says something about found his wife didn't come home, couldn't find her, and he's going like sleepless nights worrying about her, trying to figure out what the shit happened. He's going down into a downward spiral, and he starts seeing shit, nightmares and all kinds of crazy shit. He doesn't know what the fuck's going on, supposedly. But yeah, it seems pretty cool, man. I was just like, fuck, I never knew Jeff Daniels did a horror movie. I mean, pretty cool. I'll review this later, or I know not everybody likes the word review, but I will tell you my opinion on it when I'm done watching it. And this movie, I've never seen anybody talk about it really, but it's in the horror section. It's a pretty crazy fucking movie. Like, it's the little girl who lives down the lane with Jodie Foster. This shit, man, one day I was just watching television, like regular television, like 5 months ago, and I've never even heard of this movie. And it was just on TV, and I start watching like in the middle of the movie, and then I got sucked into it, And I finished the whole... It's fucking crazy. She's, like, living... From what I saw from... She was... Her dad was dead or something. She's living in the house, like, still telling everybody that he's alive. And he's, like, a writer. And he never comes out from where his room. And people and shit that's going on. And, like, she kills a couple people and throws them inside the basement there. That lady... She fucks that lady up right there. And there's some, like, goofy fucking geeky-ass kid that comes over. Likes her. She's, like, a little... She's a little fucking... You know, goddamn, she fucks that kid, you know, she starts liking him after a while. Yeah, she's a little slutty. It's pretty crazy though, man. It's cool. It's like dark. So I recommend this movie. I bought it just so I can see the beginning of the movie, because I never even seen the beginning. But yeah, I looked on Amazon and I couldn't even find it on there. And I guess it's out of print. But yeah, good movie. Really good movie, actually. And movie everybody has. I've never owned this movie, so I saw it. It was like $7, and I was like, dude, I fucking gotta get this, son of a bitch. Finally, totally uncut and uncensored, bro. I mean, everybody knows what the hell's going on here, but you know, I never owned it. There's a little insert there and shit. We all know what that story is about. And then I got one that's a non-horror movie, but this is one of my all-time favorite actors. Fucking love this guy. See, everybody calls him Buscemi. I've seen a documentary with this guy, and he said that he pronounces it Buscemi. So I don't know if you guys know that, but if you see him, don't call him Buscemi. He'll fuck you up. Buscemi. It's called St. John of Las Vegas. It's a pretty good movie. Fuck. Yeah, it's the same cover. Yeah, it's... I kind of forgot everything it's about, but... Fuck it. I'll fucking talk about it later. If you guys seen it, you know it's awesome. It's fucking good. I love Buscemi. There's another movie he's in. It's The Trees Lounge. It's like a dark comedy too. That movie's fucking good. He's just fucking awesome. God damn, I like him. Yeah. So, those are my pickups from amoebas. And it's probably going to be the last ones for a while, man. Times are super tough right now. But yeah, guys. Those are my pickups for today, actually. I was hungover all day long. I got so trashed yesterday, and I didn't want to. I don't know why I ended up going little get together, but this is what happens when you're hungover. You go shopping for movies. I try to be all cool and do this, and then quickly stop the video, but my fucking touchscreen's pissing me off right now. So now I look like a jackass, because I'm not going to upload the video onto my computer and edit it. I'm so lazy now. I bought a fucking camera for this, but I don't use it because I'm so lazy. I don't want to go and upload it and fucking do all that shit. But now I look like a jackass because I try to do the whole little... Fuck. Let's see if this shit will fucking work. Something's going down.